Good morning, coffee drinkers and news seekers, and welcome to another edition of The Daily Brew, where we are completely Google AdSense free. We're drinking our favorite coffee and reading the headlines. Patient wakes up after doctors get ready to remove organs. They thought she was dead. According to the reports, the doctors had inaccurately diagnosed this lady with irreversible brain damage, and they ignored the nurses who noticed signs that the lady was improving. She curled her toes when touched, flared her nostrils, and moved her mouth and tongue. She was also breathing on her own, even though she was on a respirator. Wow, that's incredible. So don't go to the hospital and oh my God. I don't even know what to say over that. It reminds me of that movie, I can't remember the name of the movie, where they're just like, the girl's, you know, talking to the nurse and they're cutting off her feet and, you know, they're harvesting her body right there while she's awake. You know, maybe you guys can tell me what that movie was. I saw it like once, it was scary as hell. I mean, they were so concerned with harvesting her body parts, they didn't care if she was alive. Nice. Keeping with other medical news, the revolutionary blood test that could predict how long you'll live, what ailments you'll get, and how fast you'll age. Scientists have discovered a chemical fingerprint in the blood that may provide clues to an infant's health and rate of aging near the end of life. I'm conflicted on this one because, you know, it's going to help maybe find some diseases that you might have and they might be able to work on them early. But do we really want to know how long we're going to live? And what if they're wrong? What if they say you're going to live to be 20 because you have something and then you live your life like that and then all of a sudden you get to 40. I don't know. Whatever. Here's a good one. Democrats pitch national park on where? Oh, the moon. Under the legislation, the park will be established no later than 1 year after the bill is passed and would run jointly by the Department of the Interior and the National Aeronautics and Space Administration. That would be NASA. Shouldn't we just come up with a new government agency called like the Department of the Exterior or the Extraterrestrial or something? Hey, we love government departments in this country. The measure would allow the government to accept donations from companies and foreign governments to help manage the landing site and provide visitor service and administration facilities within reasonable proximity to the historical park. They're talking about the NASA, the Apollo landing sites. After 1 year, the Interior and NASA would have to reach an agreement on how to manage the site, including how to monitor it, manage access to the sites, and catalog items in the park. The government would also have to submit the lunar site to the United Nations for designation as a World Heritage Site. Shouldn't it be an other World Heritage Site? Again, like an intergalactic heritage site or something? Since it's not really on our world. Weird. I guess we're gonna all be going to the moon soon. Did you know that? We're all going to the moon soon. Isn't that great? Wow. Maybe we can get some cheese. Moon's made of cheese or something, isn't it? I don't know. Who knows? Broward County Sheriff officers prepare for Zimmerman verdict riot plan. Because the media and some of the, let's say, race mongers out there, like Mr. Al Sharpton and such, have been fomenting this hatred and getting people riled up just in case Zimmerman is acquitted of the charges. And if anybody has been paying attention to that, the prosecution's case is pretty much in the toilet. Mm-hmm. So Zimmerman is probably going to walk. So the county is preparing for riots. And you people out there that are going to get so upset that you're going to go riot and pillage and whatever else you might do, don't do it. Stop it now. It's bullcrap, all right? Whatever is decided in the court, it's not up to you to go and riot around the city, the county, or anything like that. Just stay home. Don't be a freaking idiot. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, people signing a petition to repeal the Bill of Rights. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's great. They're so dumb, this guy's going around. He's one of Alex Jones's guys. Off the top of my head, I can't remember his name. Adam Dice or something like that. But he's going around, I hope it's a joke, but he's taking something that's saying, hey, you can sign a petition saying we need to get rid of the Bill of Rights, and people are freaking signing it. Mm-hmm. We're just a bunch of sheeple here. I can't believe it. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Any of you dummies that might have signed that and are watching? Without the Bill of Rights, what do you got? Tell me, what do you have without the Bill of Rights? Unbelievable. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's it for today, the Wednesday edition. I hope you have a great hump day. And we will see you tomorrow. Talk to you. Bye.